we have a new series here at Cultaholic. Do we get a new series, Klaxon, or anything? Yeah, that'll do. We are taking a look in this series at the many gimmicks of various wrestling stars who have been known for shifting around characters. Naturally, there was really nowhere else we could start than with one Ed Leslie. Now, you may know him as Brutus the Barber Beefcake, or perhaps the Butcher, or the Disciple, or... Well, there's a lot, okay? We'll get there. Some were good, some were not so good, but all of Leslie's gimmicks were in some way ripe for ridicule, and I cannot wait. Eddie Boulder, Dizzy Hogan, and Brute Force. Listen, I'll admit that Ed Leslie had some talent and a superstar look, but he can thank his best mate Hulk Hogan for around 95% of opportunities that he received throughout his career. Leslie began his time in the wrestling at the same time as Hulk Hogan in the late 1970s, when the Hulkster was wrestling as Terry Boulder. Naturally, Leslie went under the name of Eddie Boulder and tagged with his pal as the Boulder Brothers. Then, when Terry became Hulk Hogan, Leslie accordingly changed to first Eddie Hogan and then Dizzy Hogan. Dizzy sounds like a rizib to me, brizzes. In those early years, he also worked for New Japan Pro Wrestling as plain old Ed Leslie. Does that count as a gimmick if he's just wrestling as himself? Oh, I don't know. There is also information to suggest that once Hulk left the scene for pastures new, Leslie dropped that little brother act and went from Dizzy Hogan to Brute Force. Sadly, there's not a lot of footage from these early Ed Leslie incarnations because they all sound great, don't they? Oh, and he also wrestled as Eddie Hogan and Eddie Golden in his rookie days because a man simply cannot have too many aliases. Baron Beefcake. Leslie soon joined his bestest pal in WWE, where he was approached about using a moniker that he really didn't like. Presented with Baron Beefcake, he was a top hat wearing, cane carrying stud in tuxedo tails. Leslie didn't quite get it, or for that matter, didn't know what a beefcake was. However, he was convinced to trust the process by his mate, the Hulkster. Brutus Beefcake. Baron Beefcake didn't hang around very long because Leslie was quickly repackaged as Brutus Beefcake, the vain, garishly attired male stripper. Fun family entertainment, right? Brutus Beefcake was the first character of any real significance for Ed Leslie. It only took 8 goes to get there. With top star Hogan in his corner and the WWE machine behind him, Leslie received the push of a lifetime as a heel, successfully becoming tag team champions with Greg Valentine as the Dream Team. Brutus the Barber Beefcake. Here we go. This is the song we can all sing to. Brutus left behind his life as a Chippendale for a new occupation where he became the barber, getting the moniker after cutting the hair of Adrian Adonis. A bit of revenge for Adonis giving him a trim a few weeks prior. Now a babyface strutting and cutting into the hearts of the WWE faithful, the barber lapped up the cheers as he put his opponents out with the sleeper before chopping off their locks. Who says wrestling fans are sadistic weirdos who get off on the humiliation of others? Who says that? Show me who they are. I will tan their bottoms, then cut their hair. The barber had notable feuds with the likes of Ron Bass, the Honky Tonk Man, and Randy Savage. He also got to team with, you guessed it, his mate Hulk Hogan as the Mega Maniacs. You could practically smell the cocaine through your TV set in this era. A solid and very popular mid-card act who could also be slotted into the main event if the scenario, or his mate Hulk Hogan, called for it. Brutus Beefcake gets a lot of stick, but he was one of the more memorable characters of this era. The Mystery Man. Leslie enjoyed a 3-year run as the barber, but it came to an end when he was involved in a serious parasailing accident, which resulted in major reconstructive surgery. On the shelf for an age and unable to wrestle, WWE temporarily brought him back as an unnamed mystery man dressed in, well, whatever this all is, sending him out to attack wrestlers after matches. It didn't last long, and he didn't work proper competitions since management and wrestlers were worried about his facial injuries. He would eventually be brought back in to team with his fellow former Boulder brother as the Barber. Brother Brutai. After leaving WWE, the Beefster showed up in WCW, of course following Hulk Hogan all the way down to Atlanta. There, he was known as Brother Brutai, and his gimmick was, well, basically it was being Hulk Hogan's mate. Write what you know, they say, don't they? The Clipmaster. Of course, Leslie couldn't be Brutus the Barber Beefcake, since that was WWE's trademarked intellectual property. So he circumvented that by becoming the Clipmaster. If there are any barbers watching this video, please write in to let us know, here at Cultaholic, if any barber in the history of the trade has ever referred to themselves or other barbers as Clipmaster. I'd like to think it's like a special order where they get together and every year one of those barbers gets crowned the Clipmaster. And I don't know, they do all the admin. I'm rambling. The Butcher. Brother Brutai the Clipmaster didn't last too long before Leslie received another gimmick change. This one coming about when he turned heel on his best friend Hulk Hogan. Leslie was revealed as the masked man who had been tormenting Hogan in late 1994 and was renamed The Butcher. Now, not because he suddenly went into cutting meat. No. Nothing about a move from the salon to the meat house for our boy. He didn't become some sort of knife-wielding maniac either, no. It was because, to quote Bobby the Brain Heenan on commentary that night, he'd butchered his friendship with WCW's new Golden Goose. I tell you, the only thing that was butchered at this time was interest in WCW, because Leslie, now with sunglasses and a slightly different look, main evented Starrcade in a WCW championship match with Hulk Hogan. I've got a new gimmick idea for you, Ed Leslie, mate. How about the biggest beneficiary of nepotism in the history of the business? Isn't it catchy? The man with no name and the man with no face. Thankfully, The Butcher didn't unseat Hulk Hogan at Starrcade, much to the disappointment of devious on-screen allies Kevin Sullivan and Avalanche, the other two-thirds of the Three Faces of Fear. They decided that three's a crowd. They kicked The Butcher out, and the beatdown that sealed his exit from the group was so bad, it supposedly caused The Butcher to suffer amnesia. And so he became, I absolutely kid you not, the man with no name. I'll tell you something, I wish I had selective memory when it comes to WCW from this era. It was one big red and yellow nightmare. The man with no name somehow became just a little bit worse a short time later when he was rechristened the man with no face. Did he have a face? Well, yes, he did. Did he hide his face? No. Was it some sort of callback to his parasailing accident from years earlier? You know what, who cares? The Zodiac. Leslie didn't take getting his head caved in by Sullivan to heart, though. He later joined another of the Taskmaster's stables, the so bad, it's definitely very, very good Dungeon of Doom, this time as the Zodiac. The Zodiac was quite a departure for Leslie, as he painted his face black and white and responded only to questions asked of him with a yes or a no. For instance, oh hey Zodiac, are you still stealing a living and taking the spot of some other more deserving wrestler here in Hogan's Playhouse? I mean WCW? Yes. Oh hey Zodiac, do you reckon you and the rest of Hogan's maids could clear off so I could enjoy some wrestling again? No. Hey Zodiac, could you cut me hair for me? Oh wait, we're not doing that one anymore. That's fine. The gimmick kept Leslie in the limelight and in the mix against the Hogans and the Savages of the world, but it, along with the rest of the freaks in that group, were endemic of WCW's issues at that time, and their demise was widely celebrated. The Booty Man and Big Brother Booty. But it was all a ruse, brother! Turns out that the Zodiac was actually a mole! There's another gimmick idea. Ed Leslie dressing up as a mole, living underground. Never mind. A mole sent in by Hogan to infiltrate the Dungeon of Doom from within. Yes, after a year of trying to end Hulkamania, that bombshell was dropped. Did it make a lick of sense? Nah, of course not. Did it result in another gimmick change for Ed Leslie? Of course it did. After the scheme was revealed, Leslie transformed into the Booty Man. The gimmick being that he was infatuated with his own backside. They say he taught Billy Gunn everything he knows. The Booty Man would shake his moneymaker while accompanied by the Booty Babe, Kimberly Page, finishing opponents off with the high knee. Do you get it? High knee. It's a high knee, but if you say it quick, it sounds like high knee. That's the joke, because high knee is another word for bottom, and he's obsessed with his bottom. That's the gimmick. Thanks for coming. Please go to cultaholicshop.com. The Disciple. He'd be back just over a year later, and I will give you 86 of my British pounds, my entire bank balance, if you can guess who he was aligned with when he returned. If you guessed Ernest the Cat Miller, I'm very sorry, you are bang wrong. If you said Hulk Hogan, congratulations, you're a little bit richer. Of course it was Hogan. It's always Hogan. Again, to be fair to Leslie, he at least tried something properly different this time, to the point that he, as the Disciple, was almost unrecognizable. He had a big beard, he wore tinted shades, and he was decked out in biker gear when guarding the body of Hollywood Hogan, though his true identity was very soon revealed. The Disciple was always on hand to run interference and help with a beatdown, and to be honest, it might have been the best use of Brother Brutai at that point. The Disciple's most memorable moment came when he was kidnapped by the Ultimate Warrior during his feud with Hulk Hogan. You remember the one where Ultimate Warrior comes out and talks for ages and Hogan wants his win back and there's the teleporting and the smoke and the fire that won't fire at Halloween Havoc. It's all good times. We saw the Disciple get brainwashed and subsequently turn on Hogan, dropping the NWO in favor of the OWN, the One Warrior Nation. I imagine it was the promise of a full scholarship at Warrior University that tipped it over the edge. Anyway, that was basically it for Ed Leslie's big-time pro wrestling career, as he then faded into obscurity and entered semi-retirement, usually wrestling and appearing in some version of his barber persona when doing the Weekend Warrior thing. Not the Ultimate Warrior, we're not going back into that again. All told, Ed Leslie, who became a WWE Hall of Famer in 2019, wrestled under a total of 18 different names and gimmicks. That has to be some sort of record. Do you have a favorite? Of course you do. We all have a favorite. Let me know your favorite Ed Leslie gimmick in the comments below. Please note that if you say the Booty Man, I'll probably get your hard drive searched. My name's Tom Campbell from cultaholic.com. Stay safe. Love you. Bye.